And we're back now. President Trump is doing two things he loves. He's slamming the media and bragging about polls. Here's what he tweeted today. He said, "Can you believe that with all the made-up, unsourced stories I get from the fake news media, together with the $10 million Russian witch hunt, there is no collusion. I now have the best poll numbers in a year. Much of the media may be corrupt, but the people truly get it." So it bears repeating, though, that we are reporting facts, not so-called fake news. But when it comes to the polls, is the president onto something here? Back now with Simone Sanders, Anna Navarro, and Mike Shields. So Anna, you know, you just heard with the president, his tweet about Gallup's poll, daily tracking poll out, has his approval rating now at 43%. He is inching up. The economy is doing well. He's keeping promises. The Mueller investigation is getting expensive. His numbers are going in the right direction. Does the president have a point?
Look, the part about his highest poll numbers of the year, that's a rather low bar for a president at this term in his presidency.
But they are going in the right direction. I mean, they were at 37%
yeah.
and then 38%.
I think he's getting the benefit of the entire North Korea narrative. I think people are somewhat optimistic and hopeful. Skeptical, certainly, but you know, to see that going, that I think he gets credit for what's going on in North Korea. We don't know how it's going to end up yet, but it seems like the ball is moving little by little. I also think there's a part of the American people that are getting somewhat numb to these outrages and scandals and daily lies and statements. It's almost like, okay, this is who he is. He's not going to change. This is what we got. Let's get on with it. Mm-hmm. Some of us are never going to get over it, but I think some part of America is kind of getting numb to it. And I think he's done some good things lately. Like, for example, come out against Blankenship in West Virginia, a bigot and shameless discriminator.
Yeah. So, and people, I think people are getting used to him now. I mean, he is the president. But I mean, why do you think, Mike, that the Russia investigation is not having an impact on the polls?
Well, first of all, to my Republican friends, credit to you, Don, for having this segment on your show and talking about it. I think that says a lot. I mean, the fact of the matter is, I'm a campaign strategist. I look at a lot of polls. We're seeing this across the country in a lot of races. The generic ballot, which is the question of would you rather just generically have a Republican or a Democrat be your congressman, is also ticking in our favor. It tracks with where the economy is going. The economy is improving and people are feeling it. And when people sort of turn to a lot of the news, they see Stormy Daniels in Russia, neither one of which they think affects their lives. They haven't seen anything that's sort of the, oh, there's a real problem here, gotcha sort of issue that's come out of that. And so they think there's a lot of people that are just out of touch with what they're actually facing every day. And then when they look at the Democratic Party, they see it being led by Nancy Pelosi and a party that has absolutely no message other than let's get the president. And so when you add all those things up, it's hardly surprising that the generic ballot is ticking in Republicans' favor and that the president's approval rating's going up.
Yeah. Listen, I think you have a point there, but the news isn't always about what's favorable to people. We report what's happening. I'm sure people thought that Watergate wouldn't have an impact on their lives at the time, but it doesn't mean that the news media shouldn't report on it. We're not doing the investigation. Robert Mueller is. We're simply reporting on it.
Oh, absolutely right. I think it's fine to report on it. I think that a lot of people feel that goes beyond reporting to a sort of obsession with it, and especially an obsession with something where they haven't seen something that they go, oh, there's a real problem. So we're $7 million in, 14 months in, and it's just sort of incessantly talked about as opposed to things that they think actually matter to them. And then when they do see things going on with the White House, they see the economy ticking up, they see the president working on peace on the Korean Peninsula, they see some good things happening. And so there's a disconnect there, and that disconnect sort of favors Republicans, and it shoves Democrats completely out of the conversation.
Yeah.
So, but, you know, Mike, I think he gets measured by a different stick. He's been getting measured by a different stick since the campaign. There's a good 50 things he said and did during the campaign, which if any other Republican had said or done, would have killed that campaign. There are so many things he has done and said and that has been discovered since he's been president that would have taken anybody else's poll numbers down to the floor. If any other president of the United States had been found to have paid hush money to a stripper while his wife had just given birth, the numbers would be in the single
digits. Right, and they
digits.
Don't care.
They would be in the low
digits. They don't
care. Exactly.
Because he gets measured by a different stick. Before I have to go, go ahead quickly. Please,
so
Simone,
I think this makes sense, but the fact of the matter is Democrats aren't running. I laugh because Democrats across the country, particularly in 2017 and in advance of these midterm elections, are not running against Donald Trump. They are actually doing better and running for something. We have seen House Democrats time after time get up and talk about a better deal, what they're doing for the economy. Nancy Pelosi came out with the Congressional Black Caucus just earlier this week and put forth a bill and an economic plan that would specifically benefit Black Americans in this country. And so we saw Democrats do very well in 2017, I believe, because they were talking about the issues locally. And I think that's what we're going to see in the midterms. And while the generic ballot is shrinking, which I think is given, like, that's normal given how far out from of election we were.
Generic congressional ballot is now only 3 points. Republicans on a generic congressional ballot now only 3 points.
It is, but I really think, Don, we are still so far away from the midterm elections. And I think what you'll see is that Democrats are running out there talking about what they're going to do for folks. And what the Republicans have to say is that when they have the chance, they pass a tax bill, they get permanent tax cuts to corporate folks and semi-permanent tax cuts to regular people. Corporations do not deserve permanent tax cuts.
Simone,
what about the little
guy? I gotta go. And she's on fire, and yes, that is lightning behind her. It's thundering and lightning in D.C. Thank you, guys.
I got lightning going on here, too.
There's lightning right here. We'll be right back.